गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कैपेसिटेंस ऑफर्ड बाय द डायोड. इन दैट वी डिस्कस्ड द ट्रांजिशन कैपेसिटेंस एंड डिफ्यूजन कैपेसिटेंस. जनरली दिस ट्रांजिशन कैपेसिटेंस अपीयर व्हेन द डायोड इज इन रिवर्स बायस एंड डिफ्यूजन कैपेसिटेंस अपीयर व्हेन द डायोड इन फॉरवर्ड बायस. After that, we discussed about the equivalent circuit model of diode. In that, we discussed the three types of equivalent circuit models, that are practical model, ideal model, and third one is piecewise linear model. By using these equivalent circuit models, we can analyze the any diode circuits. Today, we will discuss about DC of diode. This DC low line of a diode is also one of the graphical methods to analyze the many diode circuits, which are much more complicated than the PN junctions. So this DC low line is also one of the graphical method to analyze the electronic circuits, not only diode. You can apply this one to any electronic device, that may be BJT or MOSFET, anything. Yes, so it is also one of the graphical method or one of the technique to analyze the diode circuits. So we are considering a simple diode circuit which is in forward bias. So the applied voltage is Vin. Here positive terminal of the battery is connected to the positive terminal of the diode, so it is forward bias. Voltage drop across this diode we are considering it is a Vf, and the drop across load resistor we are considering V0. So we are considering current flowing through the diode is If. Yes, so this graphical analysis which gives more precise relationship between the voltage and current, that means diode voltage and current, that are Vf and If, without using any diode approximation, is called DC low line analysis of diode. To draw this DC low line, we need to use KCL and KVL laws. By applying the KVL, Kirchhoff voltage law, to the circuit, we can write minus Vf minus If RL plus Vin. So from that we can write voltage drop across diode Vf equals to minus If RL plus Vin. From that we can write, otherwise you can apply KCL, If equals to minus Vf by RL plus Vin by RL. So now I am comparing this equation with the y equals to mx plus t. It is a straight line equation and which is not passing through the origin. Yes, so your y equals to if and m equals to minus 1 by rl. Why? Because this rl is constant, and z equals to v by rl. This is also constant. So from that, m is the slope of the straight line, so it is equals to minus 1 by rl. So slope of our DC low line is minus 1 by RL. Clear? And how can you identify the two points of a straight line? That means here you can observe the graph. We are taking the forward bias characteristics of the diode. It is already drawn. On that, we need to draw the straight line, where the straight line is intersects the way characteristics of diode. That point is called Q point. For that, first we need to draw the straight line. So to draw the low line, I is determined, the current passing through the diode is determined when the device or diode is short circuited. Yes. when the diode or any electronic device is short circuited, we can find the current I. When the diode is short circuited, we can say V equals to 0. So, to find the current I, we need to consider the diode is in short circuit mode. So, in that case, we can write V equals to 0. So, we indicate the point A. Point A, A equals to S. So, in this point A, voltage V equals to 0. And current I can be written as V in by RL. Yes. So in previous KVL equation. Yes. When VF equals 0, what we can write? IF equals to RL only. Yes. So whatever we have written the previous KVL equation, in that VF equals to minus IF RL plus VIN, in that we are considering device is in short circuited. So VF equals to 0, from that we can write IF equals to VIN by RL. So to determine the point A, in that current is determined when the device is short circuited. Similarly, to determine the point B, in that we need to find the voltage. For this case, we are considering device is open circuited. When device is open circuited, current I equals to 0. Yes. To draw the DC load line, we need to consider one time the diode is open circuited, and second time we need to consider diode is in short circuited. When diode is open circuited, current I equals to 0. When diode is short circuited, voltage V equals to 0. Otherwise, you can say to draw the DC load line, we need to consider voltage drop across diode equals to 0, and current passing through the diode equals to 0. By using these two cases, we can find the point A and point B. By connecting the two points A and B, we will get a straight line. Its slope is minus 1 by RL. Yes, minus 1 by RL. So now you can observe this minus 1 by RL as slope of the line. Yes. And when we are draw this DC load line on VI characteristics of diode, this DC load line will intersect at any point of VI characteristics of the diode. That intersecting point is called Q point. Yes, this intersecting point is called Q point, or operating point, or quotient point of the design of the any device or diode. We are considering this one is a diode. Yes, sometimes it is also called as DC biasing point of a diode. Clear? So at which point the diode is operating or device is operating, that point is called operating point or Q point. Clear? From that, we can say, in that point indicating voltage and current, we can say the voltage drop across the diode and current passing through the diode. Clear? So this DC load line is also one of the graphical method to analyze the diode circuits. To draw this DC low line, we need to use the KCL and KVL. Yes, by using the two, we can write the K equations. That means voltage drop across the diode and current passing through the diode. After taking the two equations, we need to draw the VI characteristics of a diode. After that, we need to draw the DC low line. To draw the DC low line, we need to find out the two points, the points A and B. To find the two points, that means we need to identify the current and voltage of the diode. For that, we need to consider diode is open circuited. In that case, I equals to 0, you will get V value. So by making the I equals to 0, you can find the V. The second time, you need to consider the diode is short circuited. In that case, voltage across diode is 0, that means by making the V equals to 0, we can find the current passing through the diode. So after finding these two points A and B, we are connecting the line, we are connecting the two points, you will get a straight line. That line is called DC load line, so which is intersect the any point of VI characteristics of the diode, that point is called Q point. That point indicates the voltage and current of the diode. That means the voltage drop across the diode and current passing through the diode. And we are discussing about the one more diode. This is Zener diode. Yes, we already know the p-n junction diode. Yes, so in that p-n junction diode, when the diode is in reverse bias, when you are increasing the reverse bias voltage, the p-n junction diode suddenly, that means in reverse bias, the p-n junction diode may damage when you are increasing the more reverse bias voltage, because sudden current passing through the junction and power dissipation at the junction will be high. Due to that, diode gets damaged. Clear? Here, this Zener diode is like a silicon p-n junction diode, which is operating in its reverse breakdown region. I said, normal p-n junction diode, whatever we studied till now, when we are operating that p-n junction diode in reverse bias at higher voltages, the diode gets damaged. Here, I am saying the Zener diode is also a silicon p-n junction diode, which is operated in its reverse breakdown region. What's the difference? This Zener diode is heavily doped diode compared to the normal p-n junction diode. Yes, this Zener diode is also experience the reverse breakdown, but this reverse breakdown region is the advantage for the Zener diode, because of this reverse breakdown region, this Zener diode is used in the particular operations or particular circuits in the electronics. So this Zener diode is a heavily doped p-n junction diode compared to the normal p-n junction diode, which is operating in its reverse breakdown region, and in forward bias it is acting like a normal p-n junction diode. There is no difference in the forward bias. Why? Because normal p-n junction diode and Zener diode both will act similar in normal or forward bias only. Yes, but in normal p-n junction diode, when you are increasing the more reverse bias voltage, that diode will get damaged. But here I am saying this Jena diode is operated in its reverse breakdown region. You may ask a doubt. When we are increasing the reverse bias voltage to the Jena diode, why it is not damaged? Yes. For that, here the Jena diodes can be designed with adequate power dissipation capabilities to operate in the breakdown region. Yes. So while we are designing this Jena diodes, we are always focusing the sufficient power dissipation capabilities to operate in the breakdown region. Yes. When we are fabricating the Jena diode itself, we are working with the power dissipation capabilities of Jena diode to operate in the breakdown region. So we are fabricating the Jena diode. For that, we are operating in the breakdown region. By considering that breakdown region, it can accept the adequate power dissipation at the junction. Clear? So when we are increasing the more reverse bias voltage to the Jena diode, the power dissipation at the junction will not damage the diode. In fabrication itself, we are considering the power dissipation of the diode at the junction. Clear? So it is similar to the conventional p-n junction diode in forward bias. Where it is a reverse bias, it is operated in the reverse breakdown region. So here you can observe the symbol of Jena diode. So it is looking like normal p-n junction diode, and Z symbol, it is indicating the Jena diode symbol. So you can observe the anode and cathode, it is looking like your normal p-n junction diode only. So in forward bias, nothing but positive terminal of the battery connected to the p region or anode, and negative terminal of the battery connected to the n region or cathode. And in the circuit here, I am keeping a resistor, that resistor named as current limiting resistor. Why? Yes. So this current limiting resistor, name itself having, it limits the current. That means it decreases the power dissipation in the Jena diode. Yes. And here I am indicating the reverse biasing also. That means positive terminal of the battery is connected to the cathode, or negative terminal of the Jena diode. Yes. So this is reverse bias, and it is particularly operated in the reverse breakdown region. That means after the breakdown voltage only. Clear? So this breakdown voltage, we know it is always depends on the doping concentration. Yes. So we know that breakdown mechanism is two types that are available in a breakdown. So in Jena breakdown, we know it will less than or equals to 6 volts. This Jena breakdown occurs less than or equals to 6 volts, and avalanche breakdown is more than 6 volts. Yes. So here I am indicating the VI characteristics of Jena diode. The operation of Jena diode is similar to the p-n junction diode only. So the forward characteristics of Jena diode and normal p-n junction diode is both are same. So here I am not discussing these forward characteristics. Coming to the reverse bias. In this reverse bias, this is special. Yes. In this reverse bias, you can observe the up to the BZ, that means Jena breakdown breakdown. So it is normally constant current, or it is increasing very minor of current. It is in very minimum. Yes. After reaching the Jena breakdown voltage, that means when you are increasing the more reverse bias voltage, a certain reverse voltage, the reverse breakdown occurs. That means
The sudden current will flow through the Zener diode. Yes, the sharp change in the Zener current is called knee current or Zener knee of the reverse current. Yes, you can observe here that intersecting point of IZ minimum and the reverse breakdown is knee point. Yes, so here this is the IZ minimum. So this current is minimum Zener current, and after reaching the Zener breakdown, the sudden current will passing through the current in the Zener diode will increase rapidly. That maximum current is IZ maximum. Clear? So here the reverse bias voltage at which breakdown occurs is called, we know it is Zener breakdown voltage. So this Zener breakdown voltage may be less than 6 volts or more than 6 volts. If it is less than 6 volts, you can say it is Zener breakdown mechanism. If it is more than 6 volts, then you can say it is avalanche breakdown. So if I am giving a Zener breakdown voltage is 8 volts, so what you can say, what kind of mechanism occurred in the diode? You can say avalanche breakdown. Why? Because Zener breakdown is maximum of, Zener breakdown can occur maximum of 6 volts, but avalanche breakdown more than 6 volts. Clear? So after reaching the Zener breakdown, it is VZ, it is already denoted in the graph. This Zener breakdown voltage value is carefully designed by the controlling of doping level during the fabrication. Why? Because based on the doping only, this breakdown voltage will decide. Clear? So in this we mentioned the two currents, that are IZ minimum and IZ maximum. This IZ minimum is minimum current through the Zener diode to maintain the reverse breakdown operation, and the IZ max is the maximum current which Zener diode can take safely maintain its reverse bias. If more than IZ max current flowing through the diode, what happens? Again, our Zener diode gets damaged. So this diode, this Zener diode can work properly in reverse bias when the maximum current, it can allow the maximum current as IZ max. When this reverse current or IZ max value is exceeds, diode may get damaged due to the excessive power dissipation in the Zener diode. Clear? So it is, this Zener diode is similar to your p-n junction diode, but doping concentration in the Zener diode is more compared to the normal p-n junction diode. Clear? So in forward bias, normal p-n junction diode and Zener diode both will act same, but coming to the reverse bias, in normal p-n junction diode, when are increasing the reverse voltage, reverse bias voltage, at a some particular point of reverse bias voltage, the diode gets damaged. But coming to the reverse bias characteristics of Zener diode, it will not damage for the Zener breakdown voltage, because if it is damaged like p-n junction diode, there is no difference between normal p-n junction diode and Zener breakdown Zener diode. The difference is when the Zener diode is in reverse bias, it is operating in the Zener breakdown region only. This is the main advantage of the Zener breakdown region. Yes, this Zener breakdown voltage may be more than 6 volt or less than 6 volts.
Again, Jenna breakdown may occur due to the again two mechanism, either it is the avalanche mechanism or Jenna effect or Jenna mechanism, any one of that. Yes. So when we are increasing the more reverse bias voltage in the Jenna diode, when it reaches to the Jenna breakdown, so the sudden current increase or suddenly current will increase in the Jenna diode, but due to this one, the power dissipation of Jenna diode junction will not damage the diode up to some maximum current IZ maximum. Clear? This IZ maximum current is the current which Jenna diode can take safely maintain its reverse breakdown. When we are increasing more than that, when more than IZ max current passing through the Jenna diode, again that Jenna diode also gets damaged. Clear? So what is the advantages of, or what are the operations of Jenna diode? Clear? So here the difference between Jenna diode breakdown, Jenna and normal p-n junction diode is only in reverse bias characteristics only. Clear? So the applications of Jenna, you should know the what are the applications of p-n junction diode. So the main application of p-n junction diode is rectifiers, clippers, clamper circuits. Rectifier is nothing but which converts the alternate voltage to the direct voltage, or alternate current to the direct current, which converts the AC to DC. Yes, so we'll discuss later. And clippers and clampers are also, these two circuits are linear wave shaping circuits. We'll discuss in circuit operations. Coming to the Jenna diode, it is similar to the normal p-n junction diode in forward bias, but coming to the reverse bias, it is operating in the breakdown region. Yes, so even we are increasing the breakdown voltage, or after reaching the VZ, what happens? After reaching the breakdown, so it is always allowing the IZ maximum. Yes, so after reaching the breakdown, when I increase the more voltage, then it is always providing the constant voltage, or it is always providing the constant current. Yes, this is the advantage of Jenna diode. Yes, due to this, we can say it is providing the constant current, so it is also called as voltage regulator. Yes, so this Jenna diode, when it reaches the breakdown region, even we are increasing the voltage, it is always providing the constant voltage, so it is called voltage regulator. It is regulating the voltage. Yes, this is the main advantage where we are using this voltage regulator. Yes, if you are taking your mobile charger, so you are connecting your mobile charger to the AC circuit, AC power supply, it is 230 volts, but your mobile required only DC power supply. Yes, so in this mobile charger, output is DC and input is AC. So in this, your mobile charger is converting the power from AC to DC. Yes, so in this you may get the output as you may get the output as constant, but before that you may have fluctuations in the power supply. Yes, but your mobile may require 3 to 5 volts, any one of that, 3.3 or 5 volts, nearly any one of that. To get particular 3.3 volts, we need to use the voltage regulator. Yes, we need to regulate the fluctuations in the voltage, and we need to provide the constant voltage, that is 3.3 volts. If I am taking 3.3 as required voltage for my mobile. Yes, so in this we need to control the voltage. So that voltage control device is voltage regulator. Here we are using these kind of Zener diodes. Yes, otherwise you can take stabilizers. So if you are taking TV stabilizer, so the output of stabilizer is connected to the TV, and stabilizer input is connected to the your AC power supply. Yes, and your stabilizer output is also AC, but the stabilizer is used to stabilize the power supply. So when you are having the power fluctuations at input side, due to that your TV may damage. To control the power fluctuations, we are using stabilizer, which provides the constant power, constant AC power to your TV. So this will avoid your TV damage. Clear? So the main application of Zener diode is voltage regulator. So this voltage regulator is may use any one of the your appliances. That may be your mobile charging, that may be your emergency torchlight charging. Yes, that may be your, what you can say, any DC devices. So in all the most of the DC appliances require the voltage regulators. Yes, so if I am designing a circuit which will provide the 5 volts as my voltage, 5 volts DC, 5 volts as my constant DC voltage, in that we are having regulator circuit. Otherwise you will get different or fluctuated voltage. Clear? So the main application of Zener diode is voltage regulator. So this Zener diode is acting as a voltage regulator in only breakdown region, that means in reverse bias only. Yes, so that Zener regulator or voltage regulator may use in clipper circuit. Again, this clipper circuit is also having the constant voltage circuit, so that will be provided by only Zener diode for controlling the output amplitude. So it is controls the output of the amplitude, that means amplitude of a signal. That may be in further you may discuss about the message signals. So in that we are controlling the output of the signal, that means we are controlling the voltage of the signal. Yes, so it is always providing the constant voltage. Yes, otherwise you can say it is used as a reference voltage in the compared circuits. In compared circuits, we are taking the one input as reference voltage, that is fixed to one, that means constant one. Again, the main application of that one is voltage regulator only. Yes, so the main application of Zener diode is voltage regulator, where we require the constant voltage. In all the cases we are need to use the voltage regulator circuit. In all the cases we are using the Zener diode. Clear? The main application of the Zener diode is voltage regulator, which is operated in breakdown region when the diode in reverse bias. Clear? Thank you.